Previously on Valley Theater. Okay, so part two of our vlog. Unfortunately, our battery, our camera went dead. We didn't realize that it wasn't fully charged. But that's why you guys love us, because we're crazy. And we do things like that. So anyway, we were talking about...
We were talking about the Shrek the Musical.
Shrek the Musical. Produced by Center Stage Academy, and the director is Catherine Tate. And we were saying what a great job these kids did. The donkey was played by Veronica Lopez. Shrek was played by Gavin. Let's see. And Fiona was played by Sarah, and Lord Fauntleroy. Lord Farquhar, I always say the guy's name wrong. I want to say Fauntleroy, and it's Farquhar, was played by Sydney Kennedy. I have to say, you guys all did a great job. Kendall, your Pinocchio is out of this world. But all you guys, all you kids did a wonderful, wonderful job. You really did. The singing, the dancing, the slapstick comedy. You know, Shrek is really about seeing yourself for who you are within and not who you are on the outside. It's about loving yourself for who you are and embracing being different. And that's really what Shrek is all about. You know, in this day and age, people can pull things apart and make it stupid or make stupid comments about it and say, oh, we got to ban this, we got to ban that, because it's not what it means. This musical is really, and this story is really about embracing who you are on the inside and loving who you are regardless of what's on the outside and loving each other. Because in the midst of all this, all the fantasy creatures get together and decide that Lord Farquhar is wrong, that they aren't freaks, that they aren't bad people, that they're all good people that can all live together, including Shrek, who's an ogre, and that Shrek can find love even though he's an ogre. And Princess Fiona can love who she is. Her one true love was not the so-called handsome Lord Farquhar, but was the so-called ugly Shrek, who literally wasn't ugly on the inside. He was a kind, good person, really, when he really embraced himself. So, and the kids did a great job of expressing this, and I hope that they realize this in their own lives, in their real lives. And, you know, don't worry about social media or what people put up on social media. Embrace yourselves and love yourselves. And remember, those of you that were in this, remember the meaning of this play. Because your director did a great job on teaching you and you know, helping you do play this part, because you all did a great job. You really were fantastic. I'm almost sorry I didn't come to see the little kids, but we had previous engagements that we couldn't come and see the little guys. But we do look forward to, is it January?
January,
they're going to be putting on the iconic musical Beauty and the Beast, and they made it a point to say the Broadway edition of Beauty and the Beast, which when I saw the costumes that they did yesterday, and
they showed this Belle's ball gown, and
one girl came out in Belle's ball gown. It was absolutely stunning, and when I saw the scenery that they did today, I can't wait, because it's going to be really impressive.
Yeah.
Really, really impressive. So, for all our followers out there, look up Center Stage Academy. Look up look up on their website, and they're from what I understand, they are going to be doing Beauty and the Beast at Combs Performing Arts.
Yeah,
so keep an eye out for that, and come support our kids because they are our future. So we want to keep our kids supported. And I think that's it. Do we have anything else?
So our upcoming shows, we are going to the Hale Theaters next Monday, Tuesday show is starting soon. It's going to be Steel Magnolias June 1st to July 27th. We'll be attending the June 8th. Show.
That's a Monday, Tuesday show.
It's only Monday, Tuesday. And then Actors Youth Theaters putting on Matilda the Musical June 10th to the 26th. We'll be attending the June 10th cast performance.
Mm-hmm.
There's going to be two casts, a telly and a book cast. So, and that's going to be performed at the Zao Theater.
Mm-hmm.
I don't have any.
Yeah, we had that. What was that one about chocolates? That's the 25th and 26th at the Tuscany Theater.
Oh, that's this week at the Tuscany
Theater. Ben and Dave are going to be in that one. We still have to get our tickets for that. We don't want to miss that.
$5 donation.
Yeah, $5 donation.
Yeah. Call for reservations.
Yes. And I think that's it.
Shout out to our Medieval Times family.
Yep. Don't forget our Medieval Times family. We'll get your tickets. They're filling up fast. So if you have a wedding, I mean, if you have an anniversary, wedding anniversary, or any kind of anniversary you want to celebrate, if you have a birthday you want to celebrate, if you just want to celebrate summer, get your tickets now because they really do fill up fast. They have all different types of packages to order from. So
I finally got a ticket, but.
Yeah, well, it's even hard.
It's hard for me.
Our daughter works there, and we have a hard time getting tickets because they're filling up fast. So if you haven't been to Medieval Times yet and you want to get there, get your tickets. Don't wait. Don't wait to the last minute because you may miss out. And you're missing out on some good entertainment, food, and just an all-round good time.
Yeah, shout-outs from them.
Yep.
Shout-out to Ben.
Ben and
Kelsey.
Kelsey and Riley and Ashley and Lexa and JT and...
And Casey.
Casey and Tony. Tony flies the birds. That's one of my favorite things. And...
But that's about it.
Yep.
And
all our people in retail, we love you guys.
We don't know all your names yet, but...
And our waiters and waitresses, you do a phenomenal job. Anthony. But I think that's it. Now, remember, this is part two. So we're going to put up part one. I don't know where we ended off. And then there'll be part two. So after you see part one... Then click on to part two. It's a new thing. Anyway, what can I tell you? We're just crazy people that don't know what we're doing half the time. But we just like to get theater out to you, and we like to tell you where we've been, where we're going, and what we've done. So to our new family, Center Stage Academy, thank you for really an enjoyable evening last night. You guys did a great job, and we really look forward to seeing more and more. For parents, they are having workshops, from what I'm told, during the summer. So if your kids are into theater and you're looking for something for them to do in the summer, contact the Center Stage Theater and see what you can do. I believe it's on their website. I did see it. Oh, summer camps. www.centerstage, centerstage.academy. So if your kids are interested in acting and you want to sign them up for workshops, check out their website. Maybe talk to somebody there and see what it's all about. So it's www.centerstage.academy, and they are doing workshops. They are having a summer camp. And I believe that's it. And we told you about our Hale Theater. We still haven't heard anything from Mesa Arts Center or...
Well, Mesa Encore just put on their Facebook page that at the end of this month, they'll be announcing...
Okay, so Mesa Encore, we should be hearing something soon. Silver Star, we haven't heard anything yet, so we don't know what's going on with them. But that's it. So take care. Have a great week. Stay safe. Stay healthy. And from Mama Dee
and David,
take care and God bless.
Bye. Have a great week.